Now the fun starts.
My name is Cameron Wicks, and I am a PhD candidate in the Food Science Department at UW-Madison. I currently study how polyphenols affect the ice cream system, especially in the creation of making a no-melt ice cream. Ice cream has fat structures, air cells, ice crystals, a serum phase, all these different things that come together, and we're able to figure out how these polyphenols are not only affecting the ice cream, but also how these molecules interact with the proteins and the fat and different things like that. Polyphenols are just a common class of naturally occurring compounds that you can find in all different types of foods. So if you think of your strawberries, blueberries, blackberries. Through a melt test, we can compare control ice cream to different ice creams that have different levels and types of polyphenol extracts. It's important to note that when we say no melt, that the ice in the system does end up melting, but the polyphenol interactions with the protein and the fat in the ice cream are able to build a network that is able to resist the flow of the melted ice. It just holds its shape very well. So if you have it sitting out on a hot summer day, it won't be all over your hand. Melting is like a whole part of the experience of eating ice cream. It not only is what a consumer expects to happen, but it also affects how taste and flavor happens while you're consuming it. So I definitely think that would be an interesting next part of this research. Ice cream already brings delight and happiness to many people around the world, so to be able to make a new novelty and with this new technology is a pretty cool thing to do.
These are all the fat globules. And
I just find it so interesting to be able to apply science to these everyday foods that you see on the shelves. To be able to understand it at that level, then you can find ways to make it better, make it different, make it more sustainable, and help feed the world.